Canva Video, I love you. Let's do this. Hey there, I'm Donna Moritz, founder of Socially Sorted, a Canva verified expert and Canva creator ambassador, and I help you grow your business with visual content. It's time for a Canva update all about Canva Video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and ring the bell to get notified when I release new videos. As always, stay to the end for a bonus hot tip. Okay, let's dive into Canva.
The first Canva Video feature I want to talk about is the Video Background Remover. Now, this was announced in September 2022 at Canva Create, the big product reveal launch in Sydney. And you may have already seen or played with it already. It's a game changer for making engaging video. And this feature makes it super easy to remove the background of any video in just one click. Before I show you a step-by-step of how this works, I have a heads up for you. Just like the image background remover, this is a pro feature, so you can't access it on a free account and will need Canva Pro, Canva Teams, Canva for Education, or Canva for Nonprofits. And personally, I think it's worth upgrading just for those two features. But the good news is you can try Canva Pro for 45 days on my affiliate link, and it's in the description of this video, so check that out below. Let's take a closer look. Here's the easy steps to using Canva's video background remover. You will be so surprised at how easy this is. So first you'll need a video. You can either upload one of your own videos, or in this case I've added one from the Canva library. There's thousands to choose from. Now just be aware you need the video to stand alone. Just like with Canva's image background remover, you need to be able to see the border of it here. Don't attach it to the background here. You want it to sit separately so that when I click on it, it will bring up all these editing features up here in the toolbar, and I want to click edit video, and then that will pop up some more editing functionality for effects, etc. And I want to choose this one here, the background remover. Now I'm going to click this and watch how quick this is. And we're done. So it doesn't always happen that quickly. It does depend on how long your video is. This guy is just celebrating. He's only it was 18 seconds long, so it doesn't take very long at all. I've noticed it's been really quick lately. It can take a few seconds, so just be patient while Canva sort of processes your video. So now that we have this guy, he's happy, he's celebrating, and he's separated, I can put him on my background there. And you can do a few things with this. I'll just show you a couple of quick examples. I can bring some confetti over and make a bit of a New Year celebration video. That's a really cool one. So any photo you can add in the background. And we can also do some fun things with text effects. So I'm going to copy him, just move him down here, and you can see now he's in front of the text. But maybe I want to play around a little bit with layers, and that's what you can do with these videos with the background removed. You get a lot more options with how you can edit things and make some cool designs. So I'm going to go to position and just move him backwards a little bit and sit him behind some of this text. So now I can go like this, and there he is. He's partying, he's excited about something. Maybe he's excited about the background remover. Fair point. And that's how you can play with it. So what do you think? If you like video background remover, then hit the like button below so I know what to create next, and also so that more people can discover this video. Let's jump into the next fun feature for Canva Video that's been rolled out. The second feature that has been rolled out for Canva Video is element timing for videos. And if you have ever wished for more control over the way that you animate elements in Canva, then my friend, your wish has been granted. Now, it's important to know that you need to use a video format in order to see the features I'm about to show you. If you can't see them, you're probably in the wrong document type. So by video format, I mean a video like this, animated social media, Instagram video, or something like a mobile video, Instagram Reels, TikTok video, or a landscape format, 16:9 kind of video. So as long as it's a video format, this will work. And until now, it was really hard to control when and how elements would animate in your video. Not anymore. With Canva's video element timing, we can control when and how elements show up in a frame. And on a template like this, I would have had to use preset animations and multiple pages to make this work. In fact, this is a version of a template that is in the Canva library that I did as Canva creator that is great and it's got music and animations and everything and sound effects, but I really think it's better to do it in a smaller number of frames, not three pages like I would have had to do in order for the user to be able to use it and edit it. And it's just much simpler. So this whole feature is such a game changer as far as editing video. So this is a stripped back video. As I said, it was three panels originally, only because I had to do that in order to control the timing. So I've now got a single panel. I want to do a more simple version of the video. There are really three sections to this. The first is the comment, then the reply, then the hearts. Now, if you look, I've already got some animated elements. I don't have to worry about those. They'll just kick on in the background. So let's get everything set up. I'm not going to touch this one because I want it just to show the whole time. Then I want this section to come in and I want it to pop. So we need to click on what we want to animate, come up here to the animate button, and then go to the one we want. I'm going to choose pop, and I want to make sure that I've made both the text and the speech bubble pop, just to get that pop effect looking really cool. Now I'm going to show you the hearts. Oh, before I do that, just double check that when you do this, you need to control how you want your animation to enter and exit. I only want it on enter for both of these. So let me just double check that. Enter and enter. Okay. Now if I do the hearts, I need to do the same thing. I'm going to individually animate these. Even though they're grouped, I can individually animate them. Actually, just let me check again. Enter. Enter and pop on enter. So now that one's done. Okay, so to see the element timing, you just need to click on an element. So, and right click on an element, should I say. Come down here and click show timing. And that will bring up the element timing in the timeline. You can see here, this one here is just a single image, which is correct, and it's showing up the whole way through the video. And I don't want to change that. That's how I want it to appear. The next one, if I click on this, you'll see that it's changed from an image to a group icon, which means that there's actually two elements here being grouped. I'm just going to go to this arrow over here. It's popped up purely because now we have a group. So if I click on that, see, I have a image and text together. Now I want to change the timing of this so that it comes up maybe at about 1 second, because I want to give time for people to read the conversation. Okay, so now that will, whoops, I need to bring this back to the start. Now that will show up partway through, which is good. The hearts are still out to sea, so I need to move them. And that's where I want them to appear. Now, see how, because I've clicked on the hearts, this element timing down here is showing up for the three hearts. So I've got three images for the three hearts. If I click back here, I'll have one image. So we'll click back to the hearts. And I want to change the timing of the hearts. So let's do these at about 1.6, 1.9, and 2.2. Okay. So let's see how that looks. I'm pretty happy with that. Let's look on full video view. That's looking great. Now, I couldn't control that without Canva element timing. It's pretty exciting, brings a whole world of opportunity to us if we're creating videos in Canva, and I think it's pretty awesome. Let me know what you think in the comments. Let's dive into number three. Third and final Canva video update I want to share is color wipe transition. And this is a feature that you can use to add really cool transitions between scenes in your video that next level your video and make them look really professional. Let's take a look at how this works. Okay, so this is a design that I made. It's a TikTok or Reels video template. Basically, the idea is that, you know, it's for UGC or user-generated content, so then the user can add in their own video footage, change it up. So I'll just play a section of it so you can see roughly how it looks. Okay, so it's a makeup video. You can see between the two frames, there's no actual transition. I'll just play this. It just flicks over to the next scene, which is not so bad because the video kind of adds enough movement to keep it sort of entertaining. But I want to check out adding a transition. So to add a transition, you just click one of these plus signs here and you'll get the option to add a page or add a transition. And we want to click add transition. And then you'll see all the options come up here and we can, check them out, do a little preview of them. And that's the one I want, the color wipe. So just again, so if I click on that, that will add the color wipe transition. And the cool thing is you can change the colors here if you want to be more specific with what they are, and you can change the direction. So I'm going to choose right. You can do any direction you like. Some of these are wild and wacky, but I just want to keep it simple. And then I can do the same thing on each of these transitions. So let's color wipe to the right. And now we have three transitions in. So I'm going to play it now with the color wipe transitions. As you can see, it's quite a lot of movement. So if you're using this transition, I would recommend you just be consistent with it. Don't sort of go in all different directions. Just always, swiping to the right is sort of giving that connection between the scenes without being too over the top. So I hope you like that. As you can see, color wipe transition is a super easy transition to use. It adds a real wow factor to videos in a professional way that looks like you've had a very experienced video editor working on your videos. So I hope you have fun with it. I'll look forward to seeing what you create. Now it's time for a final tip. The hot tip is that less is more when it comes to animation. We can animate all the things now, animate text, animate elements. We can add animated stickers. We can also animate with video. But that doesn't mean we need to do all the things with every video. So if you're unsure if you're adding too much animation, then just take a look at it and maybe take one thing away. Just remember that less is more. I hope you've enjoyed this Canva update. Go and play with Canva Video. Check out the new features, including Video Background Remover, the Canva Element Timing, and the Color Wipe Transition. Have fun with it.
Don't forget to subscribe for more videos and Canva updates to level up your Canva visuals. And check out the next video for more Canva video tips. Stay creative.